Hey, this is Frank Taylor with another episode of Nature in Your Backyard. I'm pretty excited today, as I usually am, but I'm really excited because today I'm going to talk to you about another salamander species. And you know, I love salamanders. I think they're so cool. And I think I became a biologist because I had so much fun finding salamanders and trying to learn to identify them when I was a kid that's why I became a biology teacher. So the habitat I found these today is in this stream back here. And salamanders are very habitat specific, and you can find different salamanders in different places based on the habitat. This particular species likes fast moving water and with a really good flow, and they live under rocks and in leaf packs in the water and on the edge. So let's talk right here in your backyard. You never know what you're going to find. And here's to make this invasive. It's exotic. Front yard. Dogwoods are flowering. And I just took a couple swipes. Terrestrial environment.
Produce seed pollen. And it's...
So here's our salamander species of the day. This is a black-bellied salamander, and this is an adult. And you can see that the adult stage, while he's living in the water, now in here I also got a larva stage. And if you look very closely at the larva, can you see those white gills on each side of his head, on the back of his head, just above his legs? And I've got one little larva here. You can see how much smaller than the adult is. And I have another larva here. And I read that these larvae will stay in the aquatic stage for sometimes up to 3 years before they mature into adults and lose their gills.
Now I want to make sure that you know the difference between salamanders and lizards. Lizards are reptiles. Salamanders are amphibians. Reptiles have adapted to life on land with a very dry, leathery skin, and they lay eggs that are kind of leathery, have a leathery shell on the outside, so they're able to withstand some level of drying. So reptiles are like alligators, snakes, and lizards. Lizards, however, look like salamanders. Both salamanders and lizards have a long tail, four legs, and a slender body. But salamanders are amphibians, and amphibians have moist skin, live usually part of their life in the water, and have eggs that don't have a shell, eggs that are laid in a jelly, or eggs that are very moist. Salamander eggs don't have a shell. They're either laid in jelly or underneath rocks and rotten logs in a gel-like coating. So three kinds of salamander would be grouped by salamanders that live exclusively on land in the terrestrial environment, salamanders that live half their life or part of their life in water and part of their life in land, and then there's salamanders that live their whole life in water. An example of salamanders that live their whole life on land would be like the redback salamander. That's adapted to complete terrestrial life. It lives on land the whole time, and it lays its jelly-like eggs under rocks in very moist places. Then there's the salamander like we're looking at today, the black-bellied salamander, that lay their eggs in water. The larvae are gilled, like I just showed you. And then the adult loses its gills and lives and can live on land. And then the third group is the salamanders that live exclusively in the water, which would be like the hellbender. And I'd love to find you in a hellbender. They're big, fascinating salamanders.
And of course, right next to this little larva is a little crayfish. And to give you a perspective on size, let me put my finger down in here. And you can see that crayfish is hardly bigger than my fingernail. And this little larva here is only about an inch long. This guy is much longer. And he is so fast that I don't think
I could catch him in the stream unless I had a net. And you can see he's a really good swimmer. And what makes him a good swimmer? Well, look at his tail. You see how that tail is flattened and just perfect for swimming. And you can see he's trying to swim away from me while I'm trying to get some pictures of him. And that tail is one of his characteristic features because it's shaped like a keel. It means that it's triangular shaped, but the top of it is very, very keeled. It comes to a point. So if you looked at his tail in cross-section, it would be almost like a triangle. This guy is in a group called Desmognathus, and there's a very a wide number of species in this group of the genus Desmognathus. And they're really pretty hard to tell apart. And so part of this story here was the struggle I had trying to actually identify this salamander, because I knew it was something I hadn't seen before. And I went to a herpetologist who is a person who studies reptiles. His name is Matt Close. He has a doctoral degree and he's a biology professor at Radford University, and he studies reptiles and amphibians and teaches classes on them. And just like happens to me, I sent him some pictures. A lot of people will send me pictures and say, "Mr. Taylor, can you ID this?" And sometimes the pictures are really good, and sometimes I don't have enough information to really ID. So I did the same thing to Matt, and I sent him some pictures, and he said, "Frank, I really can't tell." And so I learned what herpetologists do. He wrote back to me and said, "Frank, I need a picture of the top of his head. I need an up-close view of the side of his head. I need a picture of his front feet and his back feet. I need a picture of his tail. And I need a picture of him on the top and a picture of him on the bottom." And so I did a whole bunch of pictures. And sometimes to get those pictures, I held him with a piece of cellophane or in a plastic bag just for a few seconds so that I could get those pictures. So the life history of these guys: this guy likes to live close to streams and in the stream water. They'll breed there, and females will actually lay their eggs under a rock, usually in the water or sometimes just above the water, and the female will actually guard those eggs. When the larvae hatch out from the eggs, they have gills, and you can see that these guys both have gills, and from what I understand, they may live in the larval stage in the creek with gills for up to 3 years before they change into this adult stage. They'll eat stream invertebrates. I'm a little surprised they haven't eaten this little crayfish yet. Maybe they haven't caught it, or at least this big guy here, I think, would probably want to eat it. Or maybe they're just stressed from being here in captivity. And as soon as this video is over, I'm going to put these guys back in the creek. Here's a side view of my black-bellied salamander. We can't see his belly right now, but he's got a lot of black on it. But not as much as I wanted for sure ID. But this is as close as I think we could get it. But we do know that he's in the genus called Desmognathus. We're not exactly sure what species he would be. My best guess right now that he's a black-bellied salamander. So, reviewing what we saw today. I always review because I was a teacher for over 35 years. So today we saw the black-bellied salamander. At least that's the closest guess we can get right now with the available information. Black-bellied salamanders are in a genus called Desmognathus, and we know for sure he's a Desmognathus. And salamanders in this group lay their eggs in water or right above water so that when the eggs hatch, the larva will fall into the water. And the larvae have gills. And the larva of this species probably lives in the water for up to 3 years and may emerge anytime between 1 and 3 years. And as larvae, they have gills. Then they lose their gills and become terrestrial adults. But this particular species, while we say it's terrestrial, meaning living on land, likes to really stay near the water. Remember, if you live in this part of Virginia, You live in the Appalachian Mountains, and the Southern Appalachians, one of the greatest salamander diversities in the whole world, and you can find so many different species. If you go to the Virginia Herpetological website, they'll list all the salamanders that you can find in Virginia. And be sure to look at the maps that go with them, because they'll show you what counties that the salamanders are in. If you find a salamander and it's in a county not on the map, let us know. Let the Virginia Herpetological Society know that you found one maybe outside of its range, and they can update their maps and expand that range. So it can be a really cool thing to participate in real science based on what you find. But remember, I don't want you to just watch these videos. I want you to do a couple of things. I want you to go outside and look and see what you can find. And I also want you to research things and look stuff up and fact check. So you might want to look up black-bellied salamanders and see what you can find out about those species. If you find some salamanders, have moist hands first, because salamanders have very sensitive, moist skin, and the dryness of your skin can dry them out. Enjoy those salamanders, take pictures of them, and always release them back to exactly the same place you found them. Where can you find them? In streams, on land, look under rocks, under boards. On rainy days sometimes, or especially at night, they'll be out walking on the leaf litter. It's really fun finding salamanders. We live in the greatest place in the whole world to find them too. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Nature in Your Backyard. We're here streamside in Virginia's backyard, the Appalachian Mountains. Go out, see what you can find. Fact check me, look stuff up when you get the name of something. Send me pictures of what you found. I love seeing your pictures, and send me comments. So, Nature in Your Backyard, we'll see you again soon.